Well, we've been joined in the studio by Douglas Murray, Associate Director of the Henry Jackson Society, a foreign affairs think tank. Welcome to the Daily Politics. I mean, in a sense, though, he was a lone wolf, and you're never going to completely be able to protect communities from lone wolves with guns.
No, but I mean, there are certain things you can do to make it harder for such people. I mean, there's basically three things you need to carry out an attack like this. You need to have an ideology. You need to have the compulsion then to act in a violent way on that ideology. And you need the means to carry out an attack. Now, in America, it's a lot easier to get the means. But we shouldn't be too sanguine about this. I mean, you know, it's not legal to get a Kalashnikov in France, but it was still possible for the people who went into Charlie Hebdo's office.
But it's dramatically easier in the US.
It's a lot easier in the US. But the interesting thing so far that's coming out about this is the ISIS, Islamic State connection, which is clearly not just for this young man, but for a lot of people, provided effectively the ideological component of this. It has given the opportunity for people like this murderer and terrorist to believe that they are part of a bigger thing, believe they are part of a movement.
But there have always been ideologies. I mean, you have extremist left-wing and right-wing ideologies that drive people who are, I mean, the reports are this young man was mentally unstable, that drive people to do these things. So is there anything particularly special about it being in accordance with IS?
I'll tell you what is special about this, which is that we've seen a lot of gun massacres in the US, and there's usually enormous interest in looking at the ideology that the person has been propelled by. I'm very struck in cases like this that people don't want to know about the ideology. And let me give you a very quick example, if I may. If this gunman had turned out to have been from a Christian background, had been inspired by some far-right Christian group, you know, by now the media in the UK, the US and around the world would be looking at who he knew, which churches he attended, what preachers he listened to, and what his contacts were. And the striking thing
about that
is... Are
they not going to be doing that here?
The striking thing about that is how little of that is going on and has always been like this during the Obama administration. It was the same in 2009 after the Fort Hood shooting, described by the Obama administration as mere workplace violence. But let me just finish this point very quickly. Only 2 months ago in Orlando, Florida, there was a scandal that was not very widely picked up in the media even there, where a preacher went to one of the main mosques in Orlando, a Shia preacher, incidentally, from Manchester, and said, and because he teaches this particular sheikh, says that homosexuals not only can be killed, but must be killed now. He says, you have to kill the gays now. Now, as I say, if this had been a Christian preacher saying this and somebody had acted on it, we would be all over this stuff. But people want to say mentally ill because it's an Islamic issue.
Right. Do you think that's true?
I think we're finding this very difficult because... you know, criticising fellow Christians is very much easier than criticising somebody else's religion. But I think we've got to get over this squeamishness and call a spade a spade.
So you do agree? You think there is a squeamishness
and
there isn't as much coverage?
It's very understandable. I feel part of it. I'm a Christian myself, and one hesitates to judge other people's religions. But you just need to read, say, Ed Hussein, The Islamist, which is now a 10-year-old book, and how you cannot say that these attacks are nothing to do with Islam. And we've got to get Islam, the Islamic religion, better to police itself. Huge efforts have been made in this country to do this, by the way, amongst the communities. But they find themselves this very difficult to talk about. You will have more experience with this.
Well,
than me.
Do you find it difficult to talk about Margaret Hodge? Do you think it is time that there was more explicit association with extremist ideology that is taken in some part from Islam, even though most Muslims, the vast majority of Muslims, are not violent?
Well, I was going to make that point that I talked to all my Muslims. I've got 8 mosques in my constituency, and I talked to them about, is there any extremism or fundamentalism emerging at all among the young people all the time? So I think it's important we should talk about it. Of course we should talk about it. I think it's another really tough issue to tackle. But I've got to come back a bit to the States. I looked at the figures this morning because I knew we'd be talking about it. There's been 176 mass killings in this calendar year alone. Since January 2013, there have been 1,122 killings from mass killings, whether it's ideological in America. That has got to do with something with the gun law. So I think, you know, that is hugely, hugely important, as well as attacking the...
But do you think there is any evidence, even if Hillary Clinton decides to adopt it for her presidential campaign, and we'll come on to Donald Trump if we've got time in a moment, will it make any difference to extremely powerful and embedded gun lobby in the States?
this particular attack is primarily not about the gun lobby. It's about Islamic homophobia.
Fine, and but, answer the question. If he didn't have a gun, if he hadn't had an assault rifle, he wouldn't have been able to do that damage. Sure. And we've sort of talked about the ideology. Let's deal with the gun issue. I mean, is that ever going to be dealt with on the basis of politics there?
I wouldn't have thought so, but I mean, it's an American issue for Americans to deal with. I wish they would make it harder to get assault rifles. But just very quickly, sorry, this has to be said. People are treating this as if this is in isolation. Only a couple of months ago, ICM released a poll with Trevor Phillips fronting it about the attitudes of British Muslims. That poll said that 52% of British Muslims want homosexuality to be made illegal in Britain. Not on board with gay marriage, not that cool with civil partnerships. Make it illegal to be gay. That is a clear line from that belief held by a majority of British Muslims to somebody walking into a nightclub and gunning down people for being gay. And it is time that Islamic leaders in this country and around the world accepted their responsibility for this hate.
And this does come back to being able to say what British law is and the way it stands. Is enough, again, being done by politicians like you to go in there and say it's not acceptable to actually condemn homosexuality?
Well, I agree with that. And I think it's an issue of changing cultures. I mean, I again go into my mosques and the women sit on one side of the mosque and the men sit on the other. I find that doesn't fit in with my values. And I talk about it and say, why aren't the women there? I haven't talked about sexuality. Perhaps I should. And I'll take that away and think about that. And certainly within the Labour Party now, when we're thinking about anti-Semitism and how that's risen, that raises a whole lot of very difficult issues for us. So these are tough issues which we should talk about. And we should be clear that our British values on tolerance and equality, whatever your gender, whatever the issue, ought to be paramount in UK society. So I'm with you on that.
Right. And you agree, not countering enough. And there aren't enough senior people from perhaps outside as well as from within the religion countering that ideology.
Yes, but don't underestimate how difficult this is for the police, because as soon as they start, I mean, for example, we now have laws that make it almost illegal for comedians to make homophobic jokes. Okay. If those laws were applied to preachers in mosques and the police went in to deal with these crimes, I mean, just think about the tinderbox you would be lighting. We need more conversation, we need more understanding, and we need to extend as much support as we can to moderate Muslim people who believe in integrating their religion into the values of our society.
All right.
So to help them isolate the extremists. The extraordinary thing about the world of Islam, particularly Wahhabi Islam, is how exclusive it is and how you are either a good Muslim or you're not. And it's like the most extreme forms of Christianity.
Well, I was going to say, but it's any extreme, isn't it, on religion?
Except that Christianity has never, I mean, we don't have the violence embedded into
Christianity has put down the gun.
Yeah.
Douglas Murray, thank you.